Hello all. So today we are going to talk about sovereign bond. So since last few days we are seeing there are a lot of people are talking about it. It's not good for the country. It's good for the country. So what is it? Our finance minister Nirmala Sitharaman talked in the budget that we are going to borrow $10 billion from foreign market. So before going into the pros and cons of the foreign sovereign bond, let's try to understand what is this bond. So this bond is nothing but an instrument that government uses to raise funds for fiscal deficit as well as to manage the cash mismatch. You may ask that government has been doing this for a long time. What's new in it? Well, there is a difference. Earlier government has been doing it in the domestic market in form of the rupees. But this time they are going to do it in the international market in form of foreign currency as a dollar or a Japanese currency. So the difference becomes is earlier the risk was with the investor, but this time the risk of the exchange rate is on the government. Now let's try to understand why it is important. If government want to issue a bond in international market, there are a lot of criteria that government has to fulfill. So we have to be registered under Global Dollar Index. So as a part of this process, we have to be transparent and disclose all the records that we have, our growth plan, all the losses that we have seen, all the subsidiary, and everything has to be listed there. So this will bring more transparency into the system, because as we see today, there are a lot of data the government is hiding. When CAG report comes, a lot of things are coming, but when the government present the same data, it is different. So the first benefit we are going to get is the transparency. Second benefit, there is something called crowding effect. So what happens today when government borrow money from the domestic market? So in the market, the money left for the private investors are less. And so the interest rate goes high for those investors. This is called crowding effect. If government is borrowing from international market, so the money in circulation in the domestic market, there is not much impact, and so the interest rate will come down. Third, the interest rate that government is borrowing it. In the country, if they borrow money in India, so government have to pay 6 to 7% around. If the same money, if government is going to borrow from international market, the interest rate is going to be, let's say 3 to 4%. So there we are going to save some interest. You can ask, when there are so many benefits, why people are craving about it? What is wrong? What are the risks associated? Well, yes, it is not risk-free. Let's try to understand what are those risks. The major risk that we see is the exchange rate risk. Let's try to understand it. What is it? As of now, the dollar costs 70 rupees. So a government, let's say the bond price is $100. So in Indian rupees, it is going to be 7,000 rupees. After a year, the dollar goes up and value of $1 is 85 rupees. So as you could see, there is a difference of 15 rupees in the principal. Forget about interest. In the principal itself, government have to pay more money. So the one of the risk is how stable our currency is. If there is an instability, we have to pay more. And if rupee becomes stronger in compared to dollar, we have to pay less. This is the first risk. Coming to the second risk, when foreign currency comes into our market, inflow of the currency will lead to the excess supply of the money. This could lead to inflation. So to overcome this, RBI has to neutralize the same by issuing more bonds in the domestic market and take the money from the market. So this way, as we were expecting earlier, that the money, more money would be available for the private investors, will not be that high as we are expecting. It will not be the same amount how much we are going to borrow. Now, third risk is, there are a lot of economies that has done this and were not very successful. Some of the examples are the Greece, Argentina, Thailand. But then we'll have to understand the difference of the economy. As you all know, India economy is very strong as of today. And are you aware of the fact that our foreign loan is one of the lowest in the world? It's even less than 4%, around 3.8%. On the second side, RBI has a huge foreign exchange, around $380 billion. So if we are planning to take a $10 billion loan from the outside, it is not going to make much difference. However, there are a lot of benefit that we could see that we will be getting it. So the risk side, I see the risks are not that high, but the benefit we are able to see, there are many benefits. One more logic that people give is, we are talking for 10 billion right now. If tomorrow government need more money, government will borrow more, and this way we can go in not in a very good shape. Well, that everything has to be in a controlled manner. And if I summarize it, I think government is going in the right direction, but again, we have to see the various factors.